So I want you to listen and focus on the sound mixture I'm going to play for you, and you'll be able to pull out a 7-digit phone number. Now, it's a little bit hard because a 7-digit phone number is just at the limit of what short-term memory allows you to recall unless you already knew the phone number and had learned it. So I'm going to play this sound mixture for you, and I want you to listen carefully for the 7-digit phone number that's spoken by a male, metallic-sounding voice. So here we go.
3, 5, 3, 4, 3, 4, 2.
Kind of practicing in my own head saying it back. Can you remember it? Write it down. And if you wrote down all 7 digits, you should have gotten 3, 5, 3, 4, 3, 4, 2. But what's interesting about this process is you may or may not be able to say anything about what else was in that sound mixture. Because when the brain is focused on one thing, it actually suppresses the information that it thinks is irrelevant at that moment. And this process is so strong that you can actually see it in neural activity when you measure things on the scalp even. You can see responses to attended, but not to unattended sounds. So what I'm going to do now is play exactly the same sound mixture, but instead of listening for the phone number, listen for my voice in the background.
3, 5, 3, 4, 3, 4, 2.
Because it's hard to understand two things at once. That's not what we naturally do, and that's not how we naturally process sound.